New Hubbard. Why? Has it got a name?
No, it's a 355, Gibson 355.
Beautiful.
So cool, yeah. Because it costs $355 new.
150 quid. When?
Well, when they first came out, 1959, I think.
How old are you then? But I saw you playing that very guitar at the 606, and Clapton was there. And he borrowed it and played on it.
That's right, yeah.
I think we got a photo of that. Who else has played it apart from you?
It used to belong to Steve Barrett, who was the Faces.
Oh dear.
Yeah, yeah. And funnily enough, I did a session for him when he was living out in Essex, in a little farmhouse out there. And I got the guitar out and sold it to him. You know, I said, I believe you used to own this. And said, oh yeah, it was never quite right, that one. I just... well, anyway, there we are.
So all the people you play with, it's mind-boggling, isn't it? Brian Ferry, well, we started with the Grease Band. Was that your first band at school, from school?
No, first band I was in bore my name, although I wasn't the leader of the band. It bore my name because everybody else in the band was paranoid about the tax man.
Not Hubbard's
Cupboard,
was it?
No, it's the Neil Hubbard Quartet.
Oh, cool.
Very.
And that was what, at school?
I just left school. We used to play around Stilton and Peterborough. But Colin Hodgkinson was a bass player from Backdoor. Adrian Tittman was a keyboard player who's made a great living in the States. And the other guy was Rex Gates, who was the drummer who used to play with Emil Ford back in the 50s, late 50s, early 60s, yeah.
Have you always made a living doing music then? Did you ever have a proper job or not?
No, never had a proper job. Been, you know, doing nothing a lot of the time, but I've always...
You've stuck with your guitar skill, no?
Yeah, I never ever thought that I would be able to make a living from it. I always just... did it because I was having fun, and you know, 1 year became 2 years. Now the Grease Band started off in Sheffield.
Is that Greasy?
Do you know what a Grease Band is?
No.
It's a thing. And it's a rag which is tied around a fruit tree and smothered in grease. It stops the insects from climbing the tree.
So who
and that's
that
called
name?
A grease band. I've no idea.
Yeah, man, that's bloody.
But I wasn't with the original guys. I played with the incarnation that came after the Grease Band that backed Joe Cocker.
I know I've followed your career a bit. I've done gigs with you in the past, but you were Vinegar Joe and.
No, I wasn't. I was never with Vinegar Joe.
Juicy Lucy.
I played with Robert Palmer, who I believe was with Vinegar Joe, wasn't he?
Right. I thought you weren't in...
No, I wasn't in Vinegar Joe.
Who was with Carol Grimes? Who was that mob, that band?
She had a variety of bands.
You weren't in that?
I played with Carol quite a bit because we were an item for a number of years. And so I did a lot with Carol. But I think the band at the time that I was playing with her was called the London Boogie Band. So Carol is still going strong now, you know, performing and teaching and stuff. Yeah.
I mean, I've interviewed old Frank and Kokomo. That's a lovely story. And Jim Mullins. Were you in it with Jim Mullins as well? Two guitars?
Bloody
Kokomo.
Yeah. I believe Jim used to play with Vinegar Joe. Maybe that's the...
And of course, bloody Brian Ferry. And Live Aid thing.
Right.
And I watched the TV, and there's you on it with Brian Ferry.
Live Aid, right? Yeah. Yeah, I was a lovely band. It was a one-off band. Marcus Miller was playing bass. Andy Newmark was playing drums. And yeah, it was a fabulous band. But old Dave Gilmore was with it as well. But it was just for that one occasion, you know, for Band Aid. Yeah. But I played a lot with Brian over the years in Roxy Music and doing his
all their albums, stuff. I think O'Malley calls you Overdub Hub.
That's right, because I usually overdubbed, and if I wasn't there, I was over the pub.
Oh.